Israel's United Nations ambassador physically fed a copy of the UN Charter into a shredder to illustrate what he said was the General Assembly's disregard for the document as delegates voted to advance Palestinian membership to the world body. The stunt came just before the General Assembly voted overwhelmingly for a resolution asking the Security Council to make Palestine, which has UN observer status, a full member. Israeli Ambassador Gilad Erdan, invoking the Holocaust, World War II, and the October 7 Hamas attack, ripped his colleagues for wanting to advance the establishment of a Palestinian terror state led by the Hitler of our time. Palestinian Ambassador Riyad Mansour, speaking just before Erdan, deplored the death toll in Gaza and cited the anti-war protests at Columbia University as he implored the assembly to vote yes. Humanitarian officials told USA Today aid shipments to Gaza has slowed to a trickle as Israeli troops battled fighters from Hamas and Palestinian Islamic Jihad in the eastern part of Rafah and Israeli jets dropped bombs. Israel has ordered an estimated 100,000 residents, roughly the population of Burbank, California, to evacuate for their own safety. On Thursday night, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said Israel was strong enough to fight alone after President Joe Biden warned that U.S. arms shipments to the country could be stopped if he orders a full-scale invasion of Rafah and Gaza. The official tally of casualties in Gaza reached 34,943 killed and 78,572 injured since October 7, Gaza's Hamas-run health ministry said Friday. The resolution asking the Security Council to reconsider full Palestinian membership in the UN has passed with a huge majority. Delegates from 143 countries voted yes, 9, including the US, voted no, and 25 abstained. Ambassador Gilad Erdan of Israel closed his speech to the assembly by producing a small, handheld document shredder, into which he fed a small prop copy of the United Nations Charter. Israeli Ambassador Gilad Erdan ripped the General Assembly for wanting to advance the establishment of a Palestinian terror state led by the Hitler of our time. Palestinian Ambassador Riyad Mansour cited the anti-war protests at Columbia University as he implored the General Assembly to pass a vote urging the Security Council to make Palestine a full member of the UN representing a group of Arab states. Ambassador Mohammed Abushahab of the United Arab Emirates is submitting the draft resolution asking the Security Council to reconsider and support the Palestinian Authority's bid for full membership. An emergency special session of the UN General Assembly has opened. Members expect to vote Friday, mostly symbolic, on a draft resolution to make Palestine a full member of the world body. Gilad Erdan, Israel's ambassador to the UN, slammed his General Assembly colleagues for allowing a vote on Palestinian statehood. The Palestinian Authority's foreign ministry said the assembly would vote Friday on a new draft resolution regarding the right of the state of #Palestine to full membership, enhancing its status in the UN system and its natural place among the countries of the world. The main United Nations aid agency for Palestinians closed its headquarters in East Jerusalem after local Israeli residents set fire to areas at the edge of the sprawling compound on Thursday, the agency said. In his message late Thursday night, Netanyahu looked back to Israel's foundational 1948 war, when the new state was attacked by a coalition of Arab countries after it declared independence in the wake of a UN plan to partition the then British mandate into two states, one Jewish, one Arab,